Good morning. Today marks the start of the holy month of Ramadan, a period when Muslims around the world celebrate and spread the values of peace, reconciliation, and solidarity. Yet, even though Ramadan has begun, the killing, bombing, and bloodshed continue in Gaza. We recently entered the 6 months since the Hamas terror attacks in Israel and the catastrophic Israel onslaught in Gaza began. My strongest appeal today is to honor the spirit of Ramadan by silencing the guns and removing all obstacles to ensure the delivery of life-saving aid at the speed and massive scale required. At the same time, and in the Ramadan spirit of compassion, I call for the immediate release of all hostages. International humanitarian law lies in tatters, and the threatened Israeli assault on Rafah could plummet the people of Gaza into an even deeper circle of hell. For months, leaders have appealed for an immediate humanitarian ceasefire and the immediate release of all hostages. But the most compelling calls have come from the families of the victims of this war. I've never forget my meetings with them, and they have stood at this very podium and addressed you, united in remarkable courage and unfathomable pain. Israeli hostage families who shared their torment and anguish and pleaded for the immediate release of their loved ones, and Palestinian families who shared heart-wrenching testimonies of family members killed in Israeli bombardments and pleaded for an immediate ceasefire. As one of those family members said, and I quote, "We are not here for condolences. We are not here for apologies. We are here for immediate action." Is that too much to ask? I call on political, religious, and community leaders everywhere to do everything in their power to make this holy period a time for empathy, action, and peace. Let's not forget that beyond Ramadan, Christians will soon celebrate Easter, and Jews will celebrate Passover in April. It's time to end the terrible suffering. Now it's the time to do it, and I thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Secretary General, you meet the Israeli Prime Minister today?
Preparations are underway in Gaza's Rafah for a very different Ramadan this year. The Muslim fasting month is coming amid severe shortages of food and warnings of famine. Sahib Abu Jabal now lives in a tented camp in the southern city.
It is not like other years when the Ramadan table had different types of food. This year, God knows if we can find the food. Many people will be fasting and won't find food to break their fasting.
Nevertheless, she said they were insisting on putting up decorations and celebrating. The latest conflict in Gaza began after thousands of Hamas fighters stormed into Israel on October 7th, killing some 1,200 people, according to Israeli tallies. But Israel's relentless bombardment of the enclave has drawn increasing alarm across the world. The growing risk of famine is threatening to add to a death toll that has already, according to Gaza health authorities, passed 31,000. Efforts at securing a ceasefire have stalled. The conflict is also looming over the usually festive holy month in Jerusalem. Tens of thousands are expected every day at the Al-Aqsa Mosque compound, one of the holiest sites in Islam. The area, which is also sacred to Jews who know it as Temple Mount, is a long-standing flashpoint for trouble. Thousands of police have been deployed around the narrow streets of the old city, where the usual Ramadan decorations have not been put up. Israeli police say they've been working to ensure a peaceful Ramadan. Stall owner Hisham Al-Salami said people don't want to buy anything and no one is celebrating. This year, he says, there is no joy for Ramadan.
عادي يا سيدي يلا نكفي زين شايفينه الاسود غاب بالجهه هذه
على ما بسعيد كبير الله يرضى عليك
الله يرضى عليك
وصلت
حصول عشانها بنت يلا يلا
تعال
انا لو سمحت انا بس
يا حبيبي والله بس استاذ واقف
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله مهتدين مثلهم كمثل الذي استوقد نارا فلما أضاءت صم بكم عمي فهم لا يرجعون قل لكم إني أعلم غيب السماوات والأرض
طلع يا عبود الكاميرا
طلعت سامتي بابا
هاي
وينها